Hello, my name is ProClutch, and welcome to my first Minecraft tutorial. In this tutorial, we'll be showing you guys how to make a co-star-type mob grinder that co-star uses in his Let's Play tutorials. Okay, let's get started. First, what you will need is glass, quite a bit of glass, 4 buckets of lava, 4 buckets of water, some ladders, some half steps, some torches, and these are extra materials that I've dug out. Pickaxe and shovel. You will not be needing the diamond axe for this tutorial. Now, first you're going to want to start with a room that is 8 blocks from the surface. So it needs a 4-block drop, and then a room with 2 airspace. So 4 tall, like so. This room needs to be 10 by 10, like mine. This may take quite a lot of time digging, but you will get plenty of cobblestone for extra resources. Now, let's start off with the design. Now, you're going to want to find where your hole in the roof is, and the hole needs to be 2 by 2, right in the center of your room. And you want to take your glass and outline the hole like so with your glass and bring that all the way down. And do this on all the sides. Sorry about that. That was my sound. There we go. Now, next, what you're going to want to do is you're going to want to dig yourself out of this tunnel. Now, to just get yourself a way out, just start digging maybe 2, 3, 4 blocks in here into this, and then make a tunnel going straight up to the top of the surface, and then place your ladders. I cannot see what's going on right now. Okay. And I've misplaced my ladder on that side. Whoops. Come on. So place it on that side, isn't it? Sorry about this, guys. I mess up. And there we go. We have now dug ourselves out. So find your hole right here. And you're going to want to get your buckets of water out. All 4. Like so. And also get some cobblestone or dirt. Dirt would be easier. And place your dirt down a couple of blocks so you can get down. Like, place it about there. And then just drop down. And now take your buckets, now that you're in reach, and place 1 source block of water at every corner of the top of the mob grinder, like I did, like so. And then dig yourself out, make yourself a way out, like so. And there you go. This is what's gonna drown the mobs. Now, make your way back down into the mob grinder room. Okay. Now, what you're going to do is you're going to take your cobblestone out, and you want to place a cobblestone block on the left edge of each side of the mob grinder, like so, on all of the edges. Please excuse the lag. My video settings are on the fastest. Now, you want to take out your ladders. You can put the buckets away now. Place a ladder on each block. This will stop the lava flow, which I will show you in a later part of the video. Now, just check to make sure you've done everything correct so far. Okay. Now, you just want to break the glass where this ladder is. The reason we have this ladder here, it'll stop the flow of the glass, water, coming out. Now, you may see this happen, which has just happened for me. So, you're actually going to patch this back up. Okay. And the reason this happened is because we haven't actually filled the corners in, which we will need to do. I am sorry about this. Forgot this step. So make sure all corners have been filled, like so. Now you should be able to, and there we go, it works perfectly. So the ladder will stop the flow of the water coming out. And this is a great design because there's only one dead spot in the middle of the design. And really, if you want those things, there'll just be items there, and eventually they'll just go away, but you will still have enough items to spare. So do not worry about that one dead spot. It won't do too much damage. Okay, so next step, you're going to use your shovel or your pickaxe, depending on which material is your floor. Mine is both. So what you're going to want to do is you're going to dig a trench one deep and one wide around the whole mob grinder, like so. And we're almost done now. Oops. Let me fill that back in. And there you go. It should like that if you've done it right. So please check the steps and make sure you're on track. So next, the next step requires one more bucket of water, so I will have to go and fetch this, so bear with me for just a second, and I will go and fetch the bucket of water, and I don't know where I'm going, because I'm going completely the wrong way. Go up our little exit, and let's get our buckets of water, if I can find my water source, wherever it is at. Ouch. Why did I do that? We have some water sources around here somewhere. Go ahead and get two buckets of water. The reason for this is we are going to make an infinite spring down where we are working at, and I will show you two ways to get this done. There's my favorite way, and obviously the other way that I don't like as much. Okay, so now that we are back here, we're going to make our infinite spring really fast. So to do this, we're actually going to have to dig one corner out. Let's say this far corner over here. And we're just going to dig in like this, just that far in, and then dig these out. Dig one down into a square shape and place your... Place one source block here and one source block there. They have to be diagonally facing each other. So now you can take out of any square in the whole box and it won't ever run out of water, which is very, very fancy. Now, okay, so see how the entrance to our mob grinder is right here? This is most likely where you're going to want your loading spot, your looter spot. Excuse me for my language. My misuse of language, I don't know what to say. So here's where you're going to be using your loot This is where your looting process is going to be at. So you're going to stand here AFK and wait for your items. So what you're going to want to do is you're going to go to the opposite corner of where you're going to be standing AFK and place one source block of water. Now, as you can tell, the water is glitching up because of the ladders. They're stopping it in some funny way. Now, to fix this, we are going to use our diamond shovels here to fix this, or our diamond picks, depending on what floor you have. And you're going to dig out the block where the water stops and every other block leading up to your looting spot, like so, on both sides. So your water comes to a gentle stop right here, and you see these items are flowing right to the looting spot. Isn't that cool? Now, for the looting part of the process, we're going to just dig out like so. Get your half steps ready. And you're going to place your half steps here, here, and here. Dig one more up here. Like so. And then just place another half step around the top here, and then there you go. You got your looting. Actually, you do not want to place that half block there. You want to place it on the corner of each, like so. So you're just going to step up here, and then step up here, like so. So this is where you're going to be looting. To show you this process, I'm just going to throw one piece of cobblestone down the chute to show you how it all works. It is not done yet, but we are pretty close to being finished. So as you can tell, as you can may not tell right now, but now you can tell, this is our hole. This is where our looter is. Let's throw pieces of cobblestone down there, a couple of those, and let's go down our chute and see what kind of haul we get. Obviously, it is going to take a couple seconds because the water, especially now in beta 1.4, the water does not flow as fast as it used to. And looky here. We're starting to loot. Here it comes. There we go. Isn't that pretty cool? Okay. So now that we've got pretty much most of our blocks back, there's one still coming. But now that we've got that, we're going to move on to the next step. So, now, we're going to use our glass right here. And to make sure that pigs and chickens do not keep on decreasing spawn rates and killing your inventory, pretty much is what you want to say. You want to take your glass and place it right there, around, like so. And continue doing this the whole way around. I do not know why I just went to my inventory. I just felt like it enough. Like so. All the way around. Last one right here. Okay. There we go. Now, this is where the lava comes in. So what you're going to want to do is you want to take your four buckets of lava, like so, and you want to place each bucket of lava, wait, I think I messed up, I did mess up indeed, you're going to want to take your glass yet again, I mess up all the time, I'm sorry about this guys, and place one on top of each cobblestone block as well. Sorry about this, I forget things. So once you've done that, using a little bit of scaffolding, I would say dirt, because it's the easiest to break, you're just gonna jump up here onto your dirt and place one block of lava right there. And because you have your ladder right there, it's gonna stop the lava from flowing down.